first day was sort of the new group, and how you guys coming together? I mean, yeah. After one day.
It was a good first day, I'd say. We've been here, full group's been here for over a week now. Almost everybody's been here for the last few weeks just playing open gym and whatnot, so it was good to be here for open gym, start kind of build off that, but it was a good first day, good intensity, and we'll just build off that.
How are the rookies looking? Is there kind of the three draft picks, is there kind of a common thread with those three?
Yeah, all of them are hungry to learn. They're real hungry to learn. They bring the intensity every single day. Obviously, Jeremy sticks out a little bit with his hair color, but other than that, I'll just say they're all, you know, young, but they look ready. They feel ready, and, you know, we're going to try to do the best we can to help them catch up to game speed and just have them ready by game one.
Trey, Papa was saying yesterday that, like, every step in the process is, like, intensified even more this year. Would you kind of agree with that?
Yeah, for sure. You know, we're a real young group. We all know that we all got to be together and do it together so, you know, be as successful as we want to be. You know, as young as we are, we've had some experience. Last year, a lot of us got some experience, especially throughout the year with everything that went on last year. So I'll say just us coming together, playing as one unit, not, you know, branching off and trying to do it on our own is going to be the main focus.
Sure, you played a bunch at the backup point last season, and obviously with DeJounte in Atlanta now, there's going to be a bigger responsibility on everyone, including yourself. How do you see that point guard position as it stands right now playing out?
Right, yeah. I mean, we'll just have to see how camp goes. I'm trying to be much more of a leader this year. That's definitely something I want to continue to do throughout my career in the NBA, just be a leader, not only by example, but vocally as well. So, you know, as far as my role goes, I'm going to try to take on that role as being a leader for this group, especially at point guard. Continue to try to just do everything I was doing, though. Set up our team, set up guys in the right spots that they need to be in, and let the rest take care of itself.
Do you remember your immediate reaction when you heard DeJounte was just traded?
I think I was just hanging out with my brother back home at the time, I want to say. It was crazy. Obviously, we had heard a lot of rumors going around. You know, DeJounte was my guy for the past couple years. You know, he was someone that I was able to learn a lot from. I was very thankful for, you know, everything he was able to offer for me. Obviously, the year he had last year was unbelievable to be a part of that. So, you know, I know he's going to go out there in Atlanta and kill it this year. And we're just going to try to do what we can do here to fill that gap and continue to grow.
At some point, did you look at it as an opportunity for you? Like, somebody's got to play those minutes now that he's gone?
Right. There's for sure a big opportunity now. For sure a big opportunity there. It's just something I've been working for my whole life, though. Trying to be ready when my name's called, no matter what place I'm in, no matter where I'm at. So there's a bigger opportunity now. I'm continuing to just put in the work and be ready when the time comes.
I guess the game has gone kind of positionless, but you might be the only guy that has that point guard next to his name at this point. What's that like, feeling like you're maybe the only guy with that on your resume there?
Yeah, I mean, like you said, it's kind of a positionless game now. You know, I got to continue to add different aspects to my game to make sure I'm adapting to the way that basketball is going as well. Like you said, it's positionless, so continue to just work on my game, try to fill in the weaker areas and continue to expand the areas I'm strong in, and we'll continue to do this thing together.
You're talking about the three-point shot. Is that kind of what you focused on a lot this offseason?
Yeah, for sure. The three-point shot, continue to get stronger. You know, we switch a lot in today's game. There's a lot of different matchups, and so continue to be able to get stronger, guard different matchups throughout the game, be able to switch on the bigger guys and hold my own and do things like that.
How different is it coming into this season knowing that you are going to be relied on more as a leader and it's just everything for this team?
Right. It gets me very excited for sure. You know, it's nothing else I'll wish for myself. Like I said before, this is something I prepare for my whole life. It's a game I love and do every single day. So there's nothing else that I'll truly want for myself. I feel like I'm ready, and we're going to make the most of it for sure.
What's the conversations like with those young guys that you've been having there? Because you're kind of the vet now, you know? You're still a young man, but you're
right.
Kind of the vet now.
It's crazy because it's only year three for me, but, you know, they're asking a bunch of questions about the year, about, you know, how coaches, just everything. And so it's crazy because I feel like I'm kind of young still, but at the same time, when they're asking me these things or coming to us about these things, it makes us feel a little older. So kind of got to find the balance, but just kind of gotta do the best we can to, you know, make them feel comfortable.
Do you have like a particular rookie under your wing? Like, you know, did you get that yet or not?
Maybe Blake a little bit so far. I'll say for sure he comes to me the most about, you know, a little bit of everything. So say my guy Blake.
So, is there a point guard you kind of followed growing up and kind of modeled beside your brother?
My brother obviously. But Chris Paul for sure. You know, just because, you know, what he's able to do every single year. But all the point guards, really. You try to watch everything they do throughout the year, pick up little things, whether it's how they set up on a ball screen or the defensive things that they have, little footwork things. It's so many things. So I like to watch all types of point guards, but I was, you know, extremely lucky to have Tyus right there in the same household to watch everything he was doing.
When the rookies ask you what Pop's like, what's your answer?
Super down to earth, obviously. He cares more about non-basketball stuff than basketball stuff. So obviously, I'm going to get on this a lot, but it's for the best. And, you know, he truly means the best at the end of the day. So just be prepared.